Olay da. Hey guys, hi everyone. Appreciate your time that given, especially people in Vietnam. It's quite late now, but you're still here and watching. Support me and my partner as well, Xuyên. So today we're going to talk about a topic that's very interesting, and I think you're going to take a lot of benefit from this session. Let me just have a start on this in 1 more minute. Just make sure that all the people, they are joined a bit late, they have a chance to catch up with the content of today's session, because I think it's very interesting, and I don't want anyone miss any piece of information that I'm going to share. Okay, so I think let's just start it. So thanks for joining this session today. So my name is Hao. I'm the manager, and I have been working for Net Comedy like almost 6 years. It's a long way to go, and I'm here today to share with you one of the topic that I personally really like it, and from the management perspective, is one of the things that make me feel really confident with every single time that we deliver something to our client. Just a short introduction about my career path in Net Comedy. So I start working in Net Comedy as a full stack developer, .NET developer. I'm a Microsoft guy. So. And then I switched my path to management. I have been working as a manager for more than 2 years. And my key areas is kind of a private sector, just like the client, the enterprise, not just the public sector that we do deliver for the governments, like Danish government or British government. So my clients are just the enterprise or the company in the UK or in Denmark. So for the agenda today, we're gonna talk about my user's story. Why do I need kind of the automation testing, and why do we need it in our software development? And I also invite one of the senior test specialists from Net Comedy to share with me the advices, suggestion on applying the end-to-end testing, and he's gonna walk me through kind of the test pyramid, the end-to-end automation strategy, BDD and testing tools, and he's gonna give me example of a end-to-end test case, and I think that could be a good example for me to apply for my project as well. And coding detail with a demonstration. And Q&A, it's not like me discuss and asking him questions. You guys can also ask him, or even me, the questions. So feel free to interact with us. So let me just tell you about my story. So obviously in this session, I am the project manager, and I'm working for a client. I and my team have a client. They are having an e-commerce website which went live last year. It's quite stable, but the client, they wanted to have more and more client customers, and we do want to bring more and more values to our clients. That's why we want to introduce a few more features for this Christmas and a New Year, and in the spring of the next year as well, such as we want to introduce the wish list, online payment and shipping. I think that would be a game changer for our client when they have the online payment. And you can see that I'm maintaining the web application for selling kind of the phones, laptops, and monitors as well. But there's one thing that I need to warranty that every single time that I release something to the live environment, I'm not gonna break something that already existed, especially the MVP features, right? So if the e-commerce website have no buying, you know, feature, have no viewing product features, that would be a disaster, right? So that's why I have a first thought to ensure that every single change that I push to live environment would not impact or break existing features. So that's the key mission. So that's why I have some concerns on how can I do it with my team. So I think about like how can my team, right, ensure that new release will not break existing business flows. Not quite sure. How can my team reduce the cost when releasing the changes? Because nowadays we have like more than 200 test cases, and every single time that we release something, it takes them 2 or 3 days to complete the test suite, which include like 100 of test cases. And I think we can do something to reduce the test time for the team and bring more value to the client, reduce the time of waiting for release something to the market. And obviously when we release something quicker, our competition would be better, right? And I do have another a concern. I think most of you guys having the same in this period of time, right? Whether or not I should use my vacation during this kind of lockdown period, what should I do? It's also one of my concerns for now. Anyway, go away. But I just found a light at the end of the tunnel. That today I have Sun, he's the senior test specialist from Net Comedy as well, and I'm sure that he's gonna, you know, answer all of my questions, address all of my concerns. And let's just welcome Sun. Hey Sun.
Yeah.
Hey. Thanks for coming here and share the knowledge with me and all of shared experience with the people watching us real time now. So really appreciate your time now.
Okay, so first, thank you for give me the chance to see your stories and to help you to address this. So first, just short introduction about myself. So my name is Sun. So I have been working for Nest Company Vietnam is more than 4 years, and my key areas are for the tester, full stack tester. But I'm focusing on the technical test for my current project, where I can have the automation test for the API, for the regression test, and end-to-end test also. Yeah, so I hope that I can help you too much after this session now.
Looking forward.
Okay, so but before we go to your user story, so as I understand that your products have been go live for a long time, and now you have more features you want to ask, you want to develop. Yeah. So, but you already asked about the quality of the existing of the future.
That's right.
And you don't want your team to spend a lot of time for the testing existing of the new of the old feature.
That's right. Yes.
Yeah. So this is the story, and In my experience, that I would suggest the first you need to test manual test for the new feature you have.
Of course, yeah. I have like three manual testers in my team now.
Yeah. And then for the second round, you can consider to apply the automation test for the for this feature. Mm. So for the next time, so if you have another new feature, so you no need to worry about the existing one. Mm. So your team to have time to test the new feature as well. Have they will spend time for the another testing activities like the exploratory testing, mm-hmm. SHOP testing, mm-hmm. or others.
Cool.
Yeah. But before that, I also would like to introduce for you a little bit about the test pyramid that we have so far.
Yeah.
So we have the overview about the testing level.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we have the unit test, we have the integration test, as well as the end-to-end test.
Mm.
And the last one, so the one that I will zoom to more detail today for you. Yeah.
Which is the end-to-end testing, right?
Yep, exactly.
Okay, cool, yeah.
But before I go to the more details, so I would like to recall the some kind of the testing level for the unit test and integration test.
Thanks, yeah. I think that could be very helpful to me.
Yeah,
yeah.
So for unit test, that means your team need to test the single methods, the units of the course, so, mm. and it's usually it's done by developer.
Right.
Yeah, and I also refer some tool that you can refer. And for integration test, so that means we need to test the integration between the component, between the component and the models. They will integrate the logic as well as the database also.
Mm-hmm.
So for the integration level, you can have the some kind of back end and front end. For the front end, you can use Selenium and Projector for the Angular web application.
Yeah.
And for the back end, you can use the Postman to test the API also.
Mm, yeah. Cool. Yeah.
But for this session, we don't go to more detail about these testing types. So
okay.
We just go to the end to end. Okay. So for the end to end, is the way you need to test for the at the title said that, so you need to validate the entity of the software from the starting to the end.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the name of the name of the end to end.
Yeah.
And the purpose that you need to make sure that the whole of the software for dependencies, for the data interaction, for the communication with the other systems should be work.
Mm. Yeah. Interesting. So like from my understanding, I can see that like end to end is stand for like the first A would be like the end user, right?
Yep.
So the end user wanna interact with another end, which is a system. Am I correct when saying that?
Yeah, it's totally correct.
Yeah.
And beside that, it's also the end to end. That means you need to test the whole of the application when you start and the end.
Ah.
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting.
And I also refer some tools that we can refer to apply for the end-to-end testing.
Yeah.
We have the Test Cafe, that is a new tool on the market.
Yeah.
We have the Catalan Studio, this is a tool that Vietnamese people develop. So proud of us.
Really proud.
And we have the Cypress, and Selenium is very popular.
Yeah.
And of course, we have the Cucumber. This is a tool that I will introduce for you today.
Thank you for that.
Okay. And the next one, we will talk a little bit about the chat tree.
Mm-hmm.
So, what is the chat tree? So, the chat tree will decide the approach and the processes we would apply for the automation.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why we have the chat tree. So, some people think that the automation test just automate the manual test case. So, they don't need to have the chat tree.
Mm-hmm.
But we have a lot of issues and failure happened if we don't have the chat tree. So it should be clear that we have the approach before starting.
Mm.
So the first one, we should automate on the stable system. That means your system on the end-to-end phase should not too much change on the UI as well as for the functional.
Ooh.
Yeah. So you no need to worry about the maintenance phase, a lot of UI change, and you need to refactor your course a lot.
Mm.
Yeah. The second thing that you can reduce the automation script that you have in the integration phase.
Mm.
As I mentioned before, in the test pyramids, we have the unit test, we have the integration test before we go to the end-to-end test. So if your team also have the integration test, so you can reduce a lot of cost for the automation in the end-to-end phase. So you just need to write the behavior instead of write a lot of code.
Ah, so when you mentioned about behavior, right? I can see that, like in the last slide, when you talk about the integration testing, it's more about checking the input and the output. But it sounds like for the end-to-end testing, we just care about the flow, right? The behavior, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
So just to get a sample, so this is the first item. We just focus on the main flows instead of go to the detail. Just get a sample for the login area. So for the end-to-end phase, you need to make sure that the, you can log into the system and you do something else. But for the integration phase, you need to make sure that you can cover the key that user log in with the invalid credential, like the username and password and the with error message.
Right.
Yeah, but for the end-to-end phase, we know you need to do it.
Cool.
Okay. And the last one, this is my lesson learned. From the real world test that I have been working at the automation checklist. That's when we are working the Ross country with the people in the UK. And the test automation that designed by the Vietnamese people. And the UK people have been the people who will design the test case manually.
Okay.
So we have the process called is a review and sign off the automation trip. So the purpose of this process that we need to make sure that the automation trip cover all of the test steps in the test case design.
Right.
And the important thing that we can adjust with the team about the automation. So because in the past we also have the gap between the automation team, manual team, and for the whole team. Because they don't know exactly what automation does and how can they trust the automation.
Right.
When they do the regression test or the end-to-end test. So that's the reason why we should have the sign-off process to for the BO or the stakeholder, the key stakeholder to review and sign-off. And if the automation script have been signed up, that means we can use it for the regression test.
Cool, yeah. And if, thanks for that. And I think we have a very good question from Hoa Pham. She just posted a comment on our channel that, that what if we don't have any code to reuse? Like if we don't have like unit tests or integration tests and any code existing for reusing purpose, what should we do?
So if we don't have any cost for review, so we need to write the new thing. This is one option.
Yeah. I mean, that's the obvious thing, right? So if we have nothing, just be with
us. Exactly. Yeah.
Okay. Thanks for the question, Hoa. So yeah, and I really love the cartoon there, right? So if we don't have the strategy, we keep failing. We just call it AGI. What a pen.
So if we have more time, so I will tell you more about the process that we can hand over for the review process and sign up later. Okay, so and today I also introduce with you about the one technique that we can apply for the end-to-end test. It's called the PDD.
Okay.
So, but the PDD is behavior-driven development. It's the extension of the TDD. So just short introduction about the TDD. TDD is a test-driven development, so where you can write a test before coding.
Okay.
So you can repeat the loop, refactor the test until you get the best result.
Cool. Yeah.
But for the PDD, you do the same, but you do the behavior instead of write a test. And in the PDD, the definition of the shared vocabulary between the stakeholders, the domain experts, and engineer, so they can use the same language like the Gherkin language. So as you can see in the picture, that's the Gherkin language, they just using the some keyword to behalf for the behavior. Like given is on behalf of the initial state, when for the action. And then for the expected outcome. Yeah. So it's very simple, and the whole team should be the same page.
But how are we going to use those three keywords to build up a whole test case, right? Because it's three words.
It's not just have two keywords, but this is the main keyword. So I will go to for you detail in the example.
Okay, that's going to be great.
Yeah. Okay, and today for the testing tool, I also introduce with you about the cucumber and Selenium. And for the cucumber, this tool support for the PDD, as I mentioned before.
Yeah.
So in the idea that they will using the same language for the team, so for the PA, for the PO, for the technical guys, for the manual tester, they can understand what automation does.
Yeah.
And for the Selenium, I think that the most of you know about the Selenium. It's a very popular and it's a have raised support community. So that means if you have any issue, so you can get the answer right away. And the important thing that is free. Post a cucumber and Selenium is free, so you don't need to worry about the cost that's in your team.
Yeah,
that is very important.
I think the cost usually a good reason for the client kind of excuse for not using the automation or any kind of modern technology.
They
usually say that this is too expensive. We're running out of budget. Can you just focusing on the manual thing and utilize your resources? That's what I have been, you know, receiving for a few times. But I think if something free and do kind of amazing job like this, I would love to use it and propose to our clients.
So you know that when we apply the automation test, we also care about the cost for the guy to implement the automation trip. So if you choose the tool that you need to pay the money, so the cost for the automation will increase too much. So we need to care about this. And of course, the license tool also have some benefits than the free open source. But if you can use the free open source, so we try as much as possible.
Okay.
Okay, and now I would like to give you a sample for the end-to-end test case. So this is a manual test case. It's not the automation trip. So I just explain something. So how you can refer for this one for the keyword that we use BDD techniques. So this one we are using this website to for the demo. This is an e-commerce website. It is free for you to use for the practice automation. So the first one, we open the website, and we provide the valid credential account. And then we list on the first product. This is Samsung Galaxy S6. And then we need to verify the name of the product and the price list also. And we list on the add to cart button. And we need to verify the message as here, product edit. And then we list on the cart link to on the main navigation menu. And then we should see this product onto the cart base. And the final step, we list on delete button. And then we must show that the product has been removed. So I will show you in the UI now.
I think from my perspective, these three keywords and combination of them is very close with the human words. Like we can just can we just somehow, you know, translate this kind of keywords or language into the coding?
I will show it later during my demo.
Okay, I'm very curious.
Okay, now I just explain for you more detail about the test case that I mentioned. Okay, so the first we list on the login button.
Okay.
And then we provide the username and password. That's I have read this before. And we list on login button. So as here, then we choose the first product, but you can choose whatever you want. So because I love Samsung, so I do this one. And here we need to verify the product name and price and we just add to cart.
Mm-hmm.
And a last message, we need to verify that the product edit message to show is here.
Mm-hmm.
And then let's okay.
Yeah.
And now navigate to cart. So we should have verified the title, the price, and the total price here. And then the final step, we list on the delete button. The product should be disappear.
Mm.
This is the story of the test case that I just mentioned.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so now this is the part that I really want to see. So this is the code in detail. So how we can transfer the manual test case to the automation test.
Yep.
Yeah, this one. Okay, so in this session, I will give you some kind of the scenario that we will use during the demo, run the test and show you the reward also. And of course, so for how can it's easy to automate.
Yeah. Yep. Looking forward.
Okay, so for the scenario to run, I also use the same test case, manual test case as I mentioned with you. So as you can see that on the right, we have the manual test case.
Yeah.
It's here. And on the left, we have the automation script that I have done. So how can you take a look and let me know and so see your feeling about the automation script and manual test case of you?
Let me check. How can it that easy to write in the code? So what did I do in like 3 years in the university to learn a lot of syntax and complexity if that not readable by human? But this is something crazy.
Yeah, so that's the reason why I choose Cucumber compiled with the Selenium during my demo.
Yeah.
As well as give you the reason why we should use it. So you can see that the automation script is very familiar with the test case design. So if you are a manual tester, so you read the test report for the automation test.
Yeah.
So you can understand exactly what automation does.
Very impressive.
Yeah. And if you manager or you are PO product owner, so you can get familiar with the reward for the automation test. So this is very important.
Yeah.
Okay, now and I will show you the step in the code. Yeah. Okay, so here where I implement the automation test. So as I mentioned before that I'm using the Cucumber and they support for the BDD techniques. So this is behavior driven development.
Yeah.
So the first step you need to write your behavior as here. And it is called the feature file in the Cucumber. That. And the second step you need to implement the cost for the for each behavior.
Yeah.
For example, we have the login function. You need to write a code to implement for the login function, the login behavior.
So I thought that is simple, like you just write something and the magical things happen. So behind the scenes, tons of code.
Okay, and the next step, you need to write the functional cost of the is here is here we call the step definition in the Cucumber.
Oh, okay.
And then you need to write the functional cost to implement the action on the UI.
Right.
As you can see, that I have to click on the login button.
Yeah.
I need to fill the username and password.
Yeah.
And this is the next step you need to do it.
Yeah.
Okay, and it's here. I am using the PyObjects model to handle the action on the UI. So the PyObjects model, that mean maybe is familiar with you because a lot of guys using the PyObjects model for the web application.
Yeah.
So the PyObjects model, that mean you need to define one class in the course is corresponding for the on of the web element and the functional on the web page.
So does it mean that every single page in my website want to have one class or object or page, right? In the your cucumber, right?
In my idea.
Idea, right? Yeah. So which include all of the elements in that web page?
Yeah, exactly. But we just define the element that we are using.
Oh,
we
okay.
don't need to define all of them.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yep. Yep. I thought that we have to declare all of the elements, then it would be a mess.
Yeah, exactly. And it should be more maintenance.
Yeah.
So you can see that as here, I for example, I'm on the login page.
Yeah.
And I define the username, web element,
yeah.
and the password, and the login button.
That's right.
That's enough for the login page. And I also need to have the login function.
Yeah.
This is should be handled when we put the username and password and let on the login button.
Mm.
So there are two big benefits when we use in the PyObject model.
Mm-hmm.
The first one, you can reduce your cost.
Mm.
For example, if you don't have the PyObject model, you write all of thing in the assess function.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have a new scenario, mm-hmm. you also need to copy the cost and you need to write.
Right. Yeah.
And the second benefit that it should be maintenance. It is very important for the automation test. The cost for maintenance, you need to take care about this.
Yeah.
So if you use in the PyObject model, so if any change in the UI, I mean for the button, something like this,
mm-hmm.
you just need to accept to the correct the page and you edit something.
Ah.
Yeah. And if any change in the business,
mm-hmm.
you just need to change on the behavior,
okay.
as I mentioned before.
Yeah.
So you just need to change the behavior up here.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we don't need to change a lot of things. Yeah.
Mm.
So that's the benefit. So now I will run the test and show you how it look like. And maybe you need to focus on the screen because it runs so fast. Even though that I have slipped something too much, it's more slowly.
No worries, I'm Hawkeye. So I have a good eyes and I have just had my test. So no worries. I can get you.
Okay, so for the first one, I will run the test with the bad result. So, yeah.
Let's see, what do we have? Look at my bike.
Just take a look at the screen. So the first is a login, and then it is choose the Samsung Galaxy. And let's add to cart and verify the alert message, product address, and then at product page, they will verify the title, the price, the total price for this product,
yeah.
and then click on the last button.
Yeah.
I try to sleep some time to make sure that you can capture the expected result as I just mentioned.
So thanks for doing that because you are testing on my live environment.
Yeah.
So hopefully you can just delete the item if you don't want to buy it because I don't want to like risky the application with your magical script. Okay, it's something right? Just delete it, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Cool.
Switch to the IntelliJ to show you how the reward look like.
Regarding to the report, yeah, I thought that it should be produced or created by like someone like automation tester, but it get auto generated, right?
It should be it should not manually or any kind of the automation testing tool. It should be generated automatically.
Oh, great.
Yeah, but for the cucumber, they can generate exactly what the behavior that you have done. So it should be more easy.
Oh, okay. So it sounds like by using the end-to-end testing, we can save the time for not only performing the test cases, but also save the time for producing report, right? Because producing report, it's just something like the the guys, they just copy and paste the diagram and
explain. Yeah, exactly.
I can understand it, you know, automatically, but I think it's very helpful if this kind of tool can just generate a report and helpful information, informative reports, kind of that. Yeah.
It's not mentioned for this session, but I just tell you that you can interact with any CI/CD.
So
after you post your course, it will run the unit test or the integration test or the end-to-end test. Then it will generate the test results, and you can configuration the email sent to you.
Ooh.
And at the email, you can see how many the tasks passed, how many the failed.
That's impressive.
Yeah. So you can see that we have the test result after we run the first test.
Yeah.
This is a pass result, and you can see here.
Yeah.
And now I just want to modify something.
Yeah.
How? So because I'm an automation guy, so for today, so I don't want to do something and you don't trust me. So how? So you can edit something on the expected
result.
Can you
change it to like 369?
Okay.
So I expect that there would be one failed test case.
It should be failed. Okay. And
hopefully.
Now let's see. Yeah. Okay. Now we run the test.
Oh, I'm an old man. Oh, I can see it now.
So it is the same with the last one I just run for you.
Yeah.
But now we expect the task it should be found. You can see that the price should be the total price should be 360.
Yes.
But now just it is something in my course to just change to 6 instead of yellow.
No, I done nothing. I just do nothing, guys.
Now, just wait and see the result.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
so it's closed the browser, and now we need to double check the report also.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's see, what do we have?
We need to open this one. Let's add this one.
Okay, you are.
They know exactly what's happened at that time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I just have a look at that?
Okay.
I can see the error message.
Yeah.
Okay. Which is cool. So the past behavior, it could be in green.
Yeah, exactly.
The fail will be in kind
the
of red.
Yeah.
Light red.
But for the color, you can custom. But we're using the general, the color for the bus is mean it should be green and the fail should be red.
Okay. So I think this is very helpful, like for the not only the tester but also for the developer, because they can have the screenshot, they have the error message, they know what's going wrong, what kind of behavior that caused the issue, right? So I think it's very good for bug fixing and investigation as well. So this is a very good report.
For the cucumber, we can configuration to generate the HTML report for the JSON if we want to interact with the CI/CD, and for the a loss of high of the format for the report.
Oh, okay.
Also.
This would be cool.
Oh, now we back to the topic. Okay, so during my demo, I also show you how can we write the automation test.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the summary of the step.
Yeah.
So it's just summary. The first, you need to write the behavior.
Yeah.
It's a kind of feature file.
Mm-hmm.
And the second thing, you need to write the cost for the individual of the behavior. So it's a called the step definition in the cucumber. And the next thing, you need to write the functional cost to implement the action on the UI for the web application.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And you can refer for the BioObjects model if you want. Otherwise, you can use whatever that be convenient for you.
Mm-hmm.
And the last one, you can see how we can run the test and check the result. Yeah.
Hmm. So we have another question from YouTube. Wimzer, sorry if I pronounced your name wrong, that he asks, should the end-to-end test be a part of the original code base or created as a standalone project? Like if we use the same code repo, same code base, or we have to create another code base for the end-to-end testing and have another repository for that kind of end-to-end testing code base?
It depends. So we can, if we use for the web application, so maybe you need to build instantly for another repository.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and if we don't want to have the to automate for the web application, and you just want to automate for the button, something like this. So you can write inside your code also.
Okay.
Yeah. For example, in my current project, I have do something in the testing, and we didn't use for the another repository.
Mm-hmm.
We do something testing for the API inside the coding. Yeah.
Okay. So for end-to-end testing, it's kind of preferable to have a separate code base and separate repository,
yeah.
Right?
It depends. Yeah.
It depends, but yeah, but I think I can say that lots of guys they have set up the end-to-end testing code base kind of separate with the original code base.
Yeah.
Because they have different kind of code branch strategy. They have different way of interact with the CI/CD, right? So I think it also makes sense that we can separate the code base for the end-to-end testing. Then later on, we can use it for CI/CD pipeline and other purpose.
Yeah. So sorry on that.
Yeah.
I just a summary about the feature file for you to take a look against step definition, the PyObjects model, the rewards. Yeah, and here I also provide for you some of the best practice for the end-to-end automation test as well, just general for the end-to-end.
Yeah.
So the first, the test case should be designed from the end user because we are working on the end-to-end. And so the test case should be designed from the end user view.
Yeah. Yes, I was correct on that, right? Because I told at the very early of this session that the first E would be the end user, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
And the next one, we just need to focus on the testing for the existing features of the system.
Yeah.
And the next one, a lot of people confusing about the when they decide the test case for end-to-end.
Mm-hmm.
They include a lot of scenario in the one end-to-end test case,
mm-hmm.
and it's not much sense.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have different sets of the test case, so you need to divide it into multiple scenarios.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it should be more easier for the automation to follow with your test also.
Mm.
And the last thing, this also, as I mentioned, From my lesson learned for the pre-project about the review and alignment with your team about the automation script. So now we have time. Okay, so I just spent 2 minutes to give you the process to have the review and alignment. So the first, the review should be have the formal meeting. So the people who decide the test case will have a meeting with the automation team to review and ask the question that they concern that they don't think the automation can cover on the expected result.
Yeah.
So they can ask the question and the automation team need to solve for them about the question.
Yeah.
And then if all of the question cover, so we can go to the next step should be the alignment or update the automation step if needed. And the final step should be sign off. And after the sign off, so they are confident to use this automation test to for the regression test in the future.
I think I agree with that because everything would have a limitation, especially like automation testing. I don't think that we can test whatever that we want to because there are some limitation, right? So I think it's important point that we should review and get an agreement with our client that this is what we can test and this is not in the scope and we cannot just test it, or maybe it could take a lot of time to do it, whether or not it's worth to invest on that kind of amount of effort to doing something that not really bring much value to the system. And I think those are the very helpful best practices, and especially like we have the point here is that we just focus on the key flow or the main flow of the system rather than, you know, cover a lot of the scenarios and try to replace the the manual testing, right? So replacing the manual testing is not the purpose of automation testing, am I correct?
Exactly. We cannot rely on manual testing.
Okay.
But we can use the automation test to help team to reduce the time to for the release. For example, we have the release, and if manual test you need maybe 3 days, but for if we have the automation test, maybe you have just 1 day or 2 days, because when the automation test is running, your team have the time to do other stuff, like they can do the ad hoc exploratory testing, as I mentioned before, or they can do whatever on the risk-based testing.
Okay.
So the important thing that this is increase the quality of the product.
Oh.
It's not replaced for manual test.
Oh, that makes sense. A lot of sense. Yeah.
Okay. And just summary that during this session, I hope that Hao also have some idea to resolve your story also.
Yeah.
And the people we talk with us also have some of the key takeaways.
Mm-hmm.
Like we know that when we should have the end-to-end should be used and what's the benefits of it. And you also know a lot of the automation testing tool, and today you know it's not a new tool, but it's a new thing for you maybe. It's the BDD techniques and how can we use the BDD techniques in your team. Maybe you can use the BDD for the test case design, for the automation test, and for the BA to write a user story on top. And the last thing you know about the testing tool that I'm show you in children the demo for the cucumber, for the selenium, as well as how we structure the test, like the bioobject model, the step definition, and the feature find the cucumber. Yeah.
Okay. So I think for me, I take away the point that for now I have a stable system. It's a good time for me to propose to the client that is now the time for applying end-to-end testing, and we have the free tools over there, and then you don't have to spend any money on tools. Just give it the time, and then we can just bring the mythical things to you. So I think there would be no excuse for them anymore. So it's very helpful session to me. So I appreciate that.
Yeah. Yeah. And hope that I have a chance to work with you for your team.
It's not just me. So if you have any question, guys, you are on on YouTube now and you're watching the video. Oh, we have a question. Yes. How do you combine? It's from Ronnie Anderson. So he asked that, how do you combine in BDD and TDD? Sorry if you already answered the question. My sound disappeared for a moment. So like he asked a question like, how do you combine the BDD and TDD? Can we just use both TDD and BDD at the same time?
My answer is yes, we can use the BDD and TDD at the same time. But for the TDD, we write something before recording.
Mm.
Yeah. But for the BDD, you write something after you have the course already.
Mm.
Yeah. But to be honest, I didn't have the more experience on the TDD.
Mm.
So maybe we have another choice. Yeah.
Mm. To me, I think the TDD is kind of it's more familiar with developers like me. So when I was a developer, I used TDD a lot.
Yeah.
So I just write a lot of test cases over there, and as soon as I got on the test cases that ready and green and passed, then I am kind of confident with my implementation. So.
So it looks like you write the TDD to cover your unit test, maybe?
Yeah, kind of.
Okay.
Another question. Hopefully we answer the question, Ronnie.
So, yeah.
Or I just leave another comment, right? So another question from Hui. How can handle the indie? How can handle in automation script if taking a long time to complete? To completely loading a web page?
I got your point that the page is loading sometimes slowly,
mm-hmm.
Especially when you run the test on the CI/CD via the remote machine. So, so the best practice from my side is you need to apply the correct the button, like as I mentioned that for the page object model.
Mm-hmm.
And for example, before you go ahead to handle the login page, you need to make sure that the login page should be displayed.
Mm-hmm.
So you can use some kind of the waiting functional in the mm-hmm. Selenium.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. For every class, you need to make sure that it should be visual before processing.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Looking forward to have more questions from you guys. We still have 8 minutes left.
So I hope that this session helpful for you guys because it's too late in Vietnam. So.
No, it's just a time to have a drink.
Okay.
Okay. But I think I really appreciate your time, the guys now looking watching us on YouTube, and also appreciate your time, Xuyên, to be here and answer a lot of questions, address my concern. Now I have a better understanding about the automation testing, especially the end-to-end testing. And
yeah.
I think that could help me a lot in terms of managing the project and also supporting the team to save the time, save the cost for the client. So. Thank you so much.
Just not tell about the stories. We talk about the automation test too much, but we don't have many projects apply automation successfully.
Why?
Because we have the gap between the automation team and other team. So.
So when they don't, say about the gap, what does it mean about the gap?
The gap does mean they don't understand the automation does, and they don't trust the automation script. And,
okay.
If they understand what another people do, so they will trust them.
Mm.
And when they trust them, so the more benefits that will come.
Yeah. Okay, I agree. So I think
and we need to show up the automation with your team as much as possible. Yeah.
You can do it, guys. Apply automation test whenever you can, especially in the project that you are working on. Automation tester, you can change the world.
Yeah. And at the next company, for the most of the projects, we also apply the automation test. And as here, we using a lot of tools. We have using the new technology like the Test Cafe, Cypress, or something like this, or the license tool, like the LibWorks tool that I am using for my project.
Mm.
So we consider the automation is one of core team for the agile team in that company.
Mm.
Yeah.
So there is we just had another question. Let me see. Oh, what's wrong with my laptop? That give me 1 second, please. Beep. Robel Bainey, sorry, I'm very bad at spelling people now.
Send to me.
Could you explain about the integration test, please? Is there any order to than Postman to do the test?
Okay, so for the integration test, we have the two things we need to consider.
Mm.
The first, if you have the front end, so we can use the front end like the web application. So you can choose a lot of tools now support for integration tests like the Selenium Monsol, Cucumber, and Serenity. You can use the Test Cafe or Cypress. A lot of tools support for integration tests. And for the API, you can write automation test for the backend. And I have done the end-to-end for the integration test in the my project using the API also. The first time we just think that we can use the API to test the single endpoints, but after that we can see that we can apply the full flow for the integration phase by using the Postman. And then we are confident that we can use it and we don't need to manual test till we have the new release. That's we are using it and test it in my current project also.
Yeah, I do experience the integration test when I was a developer and also leading the team now. But obviously the unit test, it just tests the piece of code that you produce, make sure that kind of specific changes gonna work in the right way.
Yep.
But when we talk about iteration, obviously it's kind of an iteration between different modules in the same system or with also like with different system as well. But it requires wider of iteration, like the iteration with the database, the iteration with the other APIs. So a part of Postman, so you can just create a lot of iteration tests in like Visual Studio, in your IDE, in your test system, by calling the API, REST APIs, like
REST Assure.
I think so. So because Postman, it just kind of give it an input and some parameters and send a request to an API, you can do exactly the same in the code base. So a part of a Postman, you can do it in your code base as well. Another question from Hui, which test cases should be automated with end-to-end?
The first the test case should be the end-to-end test case. As I mentioned, that's so now just get example. So we have the login function, login area. So the integration test case, that means you need to verify the error message when you log in with the invalid credential. But for the end-to-end, you no need to do it. You just need to make sure that you can log into the page and you go ahead for the next step. This is just example. And for the end-to-end, your version does which test case, it should be the end-to-end test case. And your team should have the people who design the end-to-end flow. We cannot using the integration test case to do the end-to-end.
And I think that there was a point that Swin repeatedly mentioned about it was like we just focus on the key flow or the most valuable flow of the system to make sure that at least we have the feature to for our user to use it. Without those flows or features, our system just ridiculous because it's not doing its job, right? So
because before we have the end-to-end testing, we also have the integration testing. So during the integration phase, on your detailed business also covered.
Okay. So I think we are there. We are now 59 minutes. So I think we are running out of time. So I think there would be a lot of question coming up, but just leave it in the comment section. we will reply your comments, your question as soon as we are available to do it. So I think this is the last TikTok of the year already. So on behalf of the organizer of the global TikTok and NetComedy, I would like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a very happy New Year ahead. And best wishes to all you guys. And make sure that you use the automation test whenever you can. And there are a lot of free tools out there on the market. So don't take excuse on that. Just do it. You can just do it. So thanks for staying with us until now. Appreciate your time and have a good night and good day to the guys in the Europe.
Yeah, see you. Happy New Year, guys. Yeah. Thank you.